The FAA issued a new airworthiness directive, or AD, for some Boeing 757-200 examples recently. The directive, prompted by structural integrity concerns, is targeted at aircraft that have been, quote, modified by particular supplemental type certificates. Let's examine this airworthiness directive in a little more detail for today's video. Once it comes into effect, the AD will give operators of 757-200s until mid-August to comment and address the concerns. The ruling is directed at 13 planes in the US, but if expanded to applicable aircraft worldwide, that figure would jump to 120 airframes. The FAA and the US Department of Transportation jointly issued the directive on June 26th. In a statement to Simple Flying on Monday, the agency said the structural concerns are around the affected aircraft's lavatory service panels. Here is the issue explained in the official document. The stress concentrations in the lavatory service panel access pan, the fuselage skin, and the stringer 22 attachment to the service panel are too high, causing fatigue cracking. This condition, if not addressed, could result in an in-flight depressurization of the airplane and reduced structural integrity of the aircraft. Although the directive calls for immediate inspections, there have not been any known prolonged groundings of 757-200s, and the believed cracking currently does not seem to pose a significant threat to safety. Delta has 109 with a current average age of about 27.5 years, while United has 40 airframes with a similar average age. New Pacific Airlines also operates the aircraft type, while FedEx and UPS have a number of 757-200 freighters. The US Air Force operates the Boeing C-32, a modified 757-200 commonly used to transport the Vice President. Adding up the numbers, that's a lot more than 13 airframes. Thus, it's unclear which airline or airlines in the US operate the handful of jets subject to this AD. The estimated cost of compliance for operators is as follows. Inspection is said to take 8 hours per jet with an estimated cost of $85 an hour. Then, when it comes to actual corrective work, installation of reinforcements will take 38 hours per aircraft. Again, assuming a labor cost of $85 per hour, that amounts to $3,230 worth of labor. Of course, parts come at a cost as well, and this is estimated by the FAA to be $3,910. And so, inspection and reinforcement for each aircraft will cost $7,820 per airframe. If inspections reveal that the service pan needs to be replaced, then that'll be 10 hours of labor and a parts cost of $250, amounting to $1,100 for this specific task. Have you flown the Boeing 757-200 recently? Which airlines and on which routes? Let us know by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.